Hello guys, myself Pawan and you are watching Optimistic Coder, and in this video we will understand why string is immutable. As we have already discussed about strings in our previous video, if you haven't watched, you can check it out in the I button or link in the description. So generally, string is a stream of characters, but in Java, string is an object. And in creating a string object in Java can be done by two different ways. One is by literals, in which string constant pool is going to store each and every literal that has been created. Or the other way is by using new keyword, where objects are created inside heap. But before understanding why string is immutable, let's understand what is immutable. Immutable means which cannot be changed. For example, a statue once created cannot be changed, because once it is molded and given a shape, it will not be changed further again. In the same way, string objects once created cannot be changed. Now let's understand this concept with the help of an example program. Okay, so let's first create a string object. So to create a string object, we need to write string, then the reference variable name, that is s, new string, and in this I will just write hello. Okay, so as we know, when a string object is created using a new keyword, first the object will be created inside the heap memory, and the reference variable here it is s, so that s is the reference variable which is going to point the object present inside heap memory. And then when JVM come across this literal hello, it will go and create a literal inside the string constant pool. So now let's perform some changes. So to perform some changes, we will just go here and perform a concat operation. So in concat, I will just write world. So it means that you are trying to perform a concat operation with the object that you have already been created. But without understanding much, if I try to print here the variable, that is reference variable s that we have already created, after performing concat operation, it will still show you that it has only hello. It has not been yet done any kind of concat operation. Now why this does happen? Let's understand. So first we have created the object, and that object has been created inside heap first, and then the literal is being stored inside string constant pool, and the s is the reference variable which is going to point that hello world, that hello object. And then we perform a concat operation using the reference variable s, and we are performing a concat. So here at the runtime, when we are creating a new object, because the hello is not, the object hello is not yet been changed, a new object will be created, and that object will be hello world. So when at runtime a new object is created, it will always create inside heap memory. And after creation of that new object, that is hello world, then JVM is obviously going to see this literal, that is world. And whenever JVM come across any literal, it is going to store that literal inside string constant pool. So the world literal will also get stored inside string constant pool. But when you run the program, JVM will see, or in Java, we have a concept called as Java garbage collection. In that Java garbage collection concept, it will go and see what all the objects that are created inside heap, which does not have any reference variable. And as we can see, hello world, which is newly created object, is not having any kind of reference variable. So because of that reason, that object will be removed from the heap. And if we try to print it, we can still find that only hello is printed out. So that's the whole point. Now, if I try to perform one more thing here, that if I give the reference s into this, to the newly created object, then if you try to print it, you can see the value will be hello world. Now, how does this happen? It has not changed the object that has been already created, but it has actually just changed its reference. So the reference variable s, which was pointing earlier to an object named as hello, but now it is pointing to another new object, hello world. So the object's content is not changed, just the reference variable has changed its reference from one object to another. That's why we are able to see it. So this is a best example to understand why string is immutable. That's all in today's videos, guys. I hope you liked the video. If you liked it, please hit like and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave a comment below. I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.